Hello to all. Probably many as me did their share of errors in 3D printing and probably will continue to do now and then. So the original Snapmaker bed has some pros and cons that I will not focus, but at some stage of your printing, something like this, or this, or even this, might happen. Grab your damaged base, get a mirror with 3mm, attention that less will make the glass too fragile, more will exponentially decrease the capability to hit your bed to impossible work values. Clean both well and also get a good glue. I use a silicone based with a good heat resistance and something to help spread the glue. Put a very, very thin layer of glue on the back of the mirror. We don't want to make a big change on the bed leveling, and also the more glue you put, the harder it will be to hit the glass. Spread the glue very well and put the base on top of it. Press it several times and guarantee that both are aligned. Wait a few hours depending on the glue and it's done. So let's level the mirrored bed. We have here two images, the bigger one with an overall view where it's possible to see the touchscreen and the adjustments that will be done, and the smaller one on the top left side where it's possible to see in more detail the printhead and the calibration paper. The video speeds will vary in 2x when calibrating and 20x when moving between calibrations. The leveling of the mirrored base does not have any different approach than the standard way to do it. On the touchscreen, select the bed position to level. Put the paper below the extruder, bringing the extruder down until it touches the paper, and you can pull it, feeling some grip, but not push it. Paper starts to bend. We just need to repeat the exact same process to all the bed positions. On half of a millimeter, like 5 or 6 times, then 1/10 of a millimeter, 6 or 7 times, with 1/20 of a millimeter, feeling the grip and the bending a couple of times, and it's done. I personally never touch the paper with a half millimeter or 1/10 millimeters. It's too risky. I only use the 1/20 mm for that kind of adjustment. Just 5 advices when leveling. First, guarantee that your equipment is leveled. Position your equipment on a leveled table and ensure that you're tacking all the screws with the same tension and perfectly in the crossed sequence. Second, do not hurry the leveling step. Do not underestimate this step. This is probably the most important part of all of your settings, configuration, dunnings, etc. Spend the needed time to do it. Third, stick to the same approach in every measure. Do not give more or less pressure just because it seems okay. Do exactly as the previous measure. Fourth, use Snapmaker calibration sheet perfectly. Is because of the sheet slip and tension characteristics, but you can use any standard paper sheet since you respect the previous advices. Fifth, do not calibrate the bed with other intention than to maintain a parallel relation between the bed and the extruder tip through all the printing area. For example, the type of filament you are going to use is irrelevant for this calibration. There are settings later that can help with that, and that is valid also for the type of bed you use. One of the real important settings in printing is the bed temperature. Depending on the material you're printing, you might need to have the bed more or less hot. And depending on the type of material you are using as bed, you might have more or less difficulties achieving and maintaining that desired temperature. I will make a comparison between the temperatures of three different situations. Only the bed surface, the standard Snapmaker material, and our glass base. Let's start by heating the surface and confirm that we can achieve 80 degrees. Going to try to get temperature on the same leveling points near the edge and center. These are the values for the heat base only. Now exactly the same for the Snapmaker rugged base. Temperature measuring tool is not bad, has a range between -50 and +550 degrees, with the variance of about 2 degrees ever when measuring from 16 centimeters from the source. The values for the Snapmaker base. Now for the mirrored base. I'm expecting some really low values here because I kept the old Snapmaker damaged base and the glass is 3 mm thick. Also, the glue also makes some spacing there. So I have my expectations really low, but I think it will compensate because the glass has a less porous base and I do not think I need that much temperature. Mainly for PLA, that is 80% of my prints. And the values for the mirrored base. I'm going to do some tests and see how it goes. The first test was a failed print due to wrong settings on the supports, nothing to do with the base. But it's possible to see that it was simple to remove and clean. The second test was exactly as the first, no adherence problems and easy to remove and clean. The third one was also with no problems. All tests were done with PLA and bed temperature at 80 degrees. There was no need to use any adherence material on the bed, and it was no need to do any leveling settings. I will continue to do some 3D printing with this bed. I believe with bigger size projects I might have some problems since the temperature is very different throughout the base area, but we'll see. Feel free to comment and make suggestions. Thank you.